Some people don't know that vehicles were completely absent from Fortnite Battle Royale for its initial explosion in popularity, but everything changed in Chapter 1, Season 4. The first vehicle ever put in the game was a shopping cart. Yes, it could hold one person in the cart and one pusher. It was pretty janky, to be honest with you, not super practical, but it was a fun time to goof around with, and if you took it down a hill, you could actually get some good speed and velocity with it, although it couldn't damage the people you hit. Today, we are going to take a trip, an evolution of the vehicles in Fortnite. What part they've played, how they've helped the game, how they've hindered the game. Welcome to the channel, everybody. Do me a favor. Tell me what your favorite vehicle of all time is. Now, we fast forward to Season 5. We got our first actual vehicle. I wouldn't call the shopping cart a vehicle. An all-terrain cart or an ATK, that's a vehicle. Well, the community knew them as the golf cart. For a four-person vehicle, could hold one driver and three passengers, all of whom could shoot at enemies while passing by and driving. The cart was pretty awesome, actually. It went fast, it could drift, it could power slide, and it changed the way the game was played pretty drastically. So how do you one-up that? Well, you follow it with the Quad Crusher. This thing shook up the Fortnite meta. It was an ATV with a power booster and a bulldozer that was built into the front of it, which would allow you to smash right through buildings, right through structures. As long as you were going at a high enough speed, you were going through it. The Quad Crusher could also fly across the map if you got airborne and boosted at the right angle, which really changed how people rotated during solo games. It came around in Season 6, and up until this point, people were pretty okay with vehicles in Fortnite. They were fun, they were strong, they weren't too powerful to be game changers, but, well, that changed. But then Season 7 came along, and it brought us the X4 Stormwing, also simply known, are you ready, as the plane. Now, the plane could carry one driver and four passengers, had a ridiculous 2,000 hit points, which made it extremely hard to destroy. The plane could fly around, activate a speed boost to fly through structures, and it had a machine gun to harass people from a distance. The X4 Stormwing, sounds like we're in Star Wars, was absolutely busted. It had to be nerfed countless times before Epic just removed it from the game altogether for being too dominant. Now remember, in Season 7, we also got the Drift Board, which was pretty awesome. It was a hoverboard very similar to the one in Back to the Future 2, and while it could only hold one person at a time, obviously, it would give you tons of movement options. People got some awesome clips using the hoverboard. I still remember seeing people going for hunting rifle trick shots on this. So Season 7 shook up the formula. But then we arrived at Season 8, and yet another meta-changing vehicle. Raise your hand if you experienced the Baller. Basically a glass ball rover, if you will, from Jurassic World. But it was built in with a grapple cable that you could use to hook onto structures and swing around. You could give yourself this tremendous speed boost or even get airborne for faster rotations. Now the Baller also damaged structures that it ran into while going at high speeds, so you could just get in a Baller in the bottom of a build fight, you could take the whole thing down in seconds. Now the Baller's low profile and excellent mobility made it an essential vehicle for competitive play, and there came a point in the game where the end of every single ranked match would have at least five people driving around in Ballers and griefing the people who were actually trying to fight. It was vaulted two seasons later, no shocker, but it was replaced by something even more busted, if that's even possible. We arrive at Season X and the Brute. Yep, the Brute was brought into the mix. It has to be one of the most negatively received additions in Fortnite history. It was a giant mech suit, could carry two people at a time, and had a ridiculous 1,250 hit points. One player would control the mech's movement while the other would control the weapons, although there were ways that you could do both jobs with one player. The movement, it was good. It featured a dash, a stomp, and a giant leap that could smash through structures like paper. The weapons, insane. Featured a close-range rapid-fire shotgun and an extremely powerful missile salvo. Then, just to make matters worse, you could self-destruct the mech when it was running low on health, which basically turned it into a mini-nuke that could kill anybody nearby. It was way too powerful, and a lot of people just stopped playing Fortnite until it was removed altogether. Epic nerfed it several times, but it never got the job done, and frankly, I'm kind of glad this one was never seen again. But that segues and brings us into the end of Chapter 1. So how did vehicles change with Chapter 2? Well, Chapter 2 Season 1 introduced water vehicles, with the motorboat being the first one. It could hold four people, it was easy to find, and it got you around the water sections of the map rather quickly, but you could also hit the speed boost while on land to continue traversing the map that way, kind of like a speeder in Star Wars. Now, it would drain your health rather quickly, but it is what it is. Season 2 introduced us also to the Choppa, a 5-person helicopter with 1,500 hit points. It was great for getting around the map quickly and dropping down on enemy players. Plus, you could just blast right of the Valkyries at the touch of a button, which, come on, it's the little things, right? Then we move on to Chapter 2, Season 3. We got cars, a few different kinds. You had the common Islander Prevalent, which held 4 players and had 800 hit points. You had the Victory Motors Whiplash, which looked more like a classic sports car and had better speeds than the first one. You had the OG Bear, which was a pickup truck with less horsepower but more health than the standard car. And then you had the Mudflap, which was a 6-wheel semi with 1,200 hit points, but not a very good top speed. Each car had a few different variants that you find around the map, and you could gas them up to refuel. Cars were an interesting addition to the game, and Chapter 2 Season 3 was very reliant on you using them to get around the map. Now we fast forward all the way to Chapter 2 Season 7. We got the Saucer. That's right, the Saucer. A 5-seat UFO with 600 hit points that could help you get around the map rapidly, albeit with rather low defenses. They were fast. You'd be pretty hard to catch if you knew what you were doing in squads in this thing. It wasn't hard to take one down, but if you knew how to maneuver it, it was good. But then again, if you had 4 players all spraying, you could probably get rid of it pretty fast. It's safe to say that it wasn't game breaking. Now we get to Chapter 2, Season 8. We got the mech suits back, but wait, there was a twist. The salvaged Brute, it was basically a nerfed version of the Season X Brute. It featured most of the same weapons and abilities, but this time around, it only had 900 hit points and much less damage per hit. Now, frankly, I'm not really sure why those adjustments weren't made back in Season X. I guess hindsight is 20/20 always, but I give them props. At least Epic got there eventually with the salvaged Brute. But then again, why even bring it back? I don't know. They just probably like having fun and laughing at us when they do these things. And now that brings us up to date so far for the making of this video. By the time this video comes out, there will be new stuff out. We'll have to do an update video down the road. But that is the evolution of vehicles in Fortnite. Now, Chapter 3 is still very, very young. And while some vehicles from Fortnite history have returned throughout the years, Epic Games hasn't quite revealed everything they have up their sleeve for the future of the game. So I end it with this, a question for you. What is the next vehicle you think, prediction-wise, will be coming to Fortnite? And what vehicle do you think we should see in the future of Fortnite? What vehicle actually makes sense to you to put into the game? I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you soon.